Have you ever struggled with creating or keeping up with a self-care routine? Or are you somebody who has a really busy school or work life and you forget to take care of yourself? Or are you somebody who only realizes that they gotta chill out and do some self-care after they burn out? Well, if any of my questions resonate with you, then you have come to the right place. Hey, my name is Claudia. Welcome to the channel. And for those who have been here on my channel for a while, I know this is a new setup and this is because I'm at a friend's house. So this is just temporary for this video. But anyways, welcome to the channel. Welcome to this video. Today, I will be sharing with you 6 easy, practical, realistic, and useful self-care activities that you can do like right now. Before we start, let's quickly define self-care, shall we? Self-care is the process of taking care of oneself with behaviors, habits, actions, and mindsets that nourish and boost one's mental, emotional, and physical well-being. With that being said, I do want to say that the term self-care has been hyped up quite a bit on social media. You see this phrase everywhere, whether it's in an Instagram caption or it's in a headline of an online magazine article. And since then, the term self-care has been diluted and simplified down to bubble baths, face masks, scented candles, and eating as much pizza and ice cream as you want. But as seemingly wholesome Instagram may paint these activities to be, I don't know if putting on a face mask could necessarily make you feel cared for, rejuvenated, replenished, and grounded. Now, I'm not slamming sheet masks, bubble baths, scented candles, and eating as much pizza and ice cream as you want. Honestly, doing all those activities in one night sounds like a hell of a night, and I would thoroughly enjoy it. But self-care is a practice, and it is also a process. It's about taking that time for yourself to just take time off from everything and to just recharge, reset, reflect, refresh, to just switch off and just focus on you and to take care of you. If you are like me and you work a lot and you find it hard to like turn off and just, you know, isolate yourself from your work, then practicing self-care can be quite a difficult thing to do. But I hope that in watching this video, you will be inspired to implement a thing or two into your day-to-day life so that you can make self-care more of a priority. So yeah, that's enough of me rambling. Without further ado, let's begin. I know this may not sound like a self-care practice, but it totally is. And this is because the state of your physical surroundings affect the state of your mind. So if you're not feeling too well, you're feeling anxious or frustrated, or you're just needing to let off some steam, consider tidying or organizing your space. It can be that shelf that's super messy, or it can be cleaning your desk, wiping down some surfaces, or you could rearrange the furniture in your room or find some new decor to spruce up your place. Creating a welcoming, relaxing, and safe space in your environment is self-care. Getting your home in order is a self-care activity. It can ease the state of your mind because just think about it. If you are doing a physical chore and you're in it in the moment, you're not focusing on like your anxieties or your worries about the past or the future. You are focused on the present. I certainly know that for myself when I walk into my room, I feel better when I know that my bed is made, my desk is clear, and every object that I own has its own place to go to. So if you're ever feeling cluttered or anxious or disoriented, check your surroundings. Is your place as cluttered and messy as your thoughts? Skincare is self-care, and for the longest time, I didn't bother taking care of my skin. I just saw it as a chore, something I just wasn't interested in, but it was only until January of this year that I decided to implement a skincare routine. And I gotta say, it's changed my life for the better because I feel more in tune with my body. I get to see like the changes in my skin and see the improvement of my overall skin health because I spend that time pampering myself and taking care of myself. And just to kick it up a notch with taking care of my skin, I try to be more conscious with the products I use. So I try to use more clean, cruelty-free, vegan, sustainably made, and more personalized products in my skincare routine. And this is because I feel like using cleaner and healthier products is a form of self-care because whatever you ingest into your body, whether it's sustenance, information, content, or skincare, it affects your mental and physical well-being. Now, I know that some products are really pricey out there and that the skincare world is so vast and overwhelming, you might not know where to begin. But I really feel like your skincare has really ticked all the boxes for me. Yours is an environmentally friendly and clean skincare brand. And by clean, I really mean clean. So every decision from the products, supply chain, and packaging is all safe, ethical, and sustainable. They are a cruelty-free vegan skincare brand that's all about being simple, minimalist, and sustainable. And that is totally up my alley. Since the wondrous world of skincare can be quite overwhelming, it can be really difficult for you to figure out what product would suit you best. So at Yours, you get to do an online skin quiz as well as a selfie analysis to figure out your skin situation, to see possible skin concerns. And you're also given knowledge on how like water, sleep, lifestyle habits, dietary habits, your climate, the makeup products you put on can totally affect your skin health. And after you do the skin quiz, you'll be recommended a personalized kit that contains a day serum, a day cream, a night serum, and a night cream. And look at how cute it is! Is beautiful. All containers and packaging are recyclable and reusable since your skincare focuses on minimizing product wastage. And like I said earlier, this is a clean skincare brand, so they're super transparent with their ingredient list. So at Yours, they have banned 1,400 ingredients that they find harmful to your skin and to the environment, whereas let's say the US FDA has only banned 30. So yeah, clean beauty is self-care. And if anything, affordable clean beauty is like the ultimate top tier of self-care. I have been using this personalized kit for over 3 weeks now, and even though you may not see a visible difference from these before pictures and this after footage, I definitely feel the difference. I've had issues with hydration in my skin. I get dry patches here and there, especially when the weather changes quite drastically here in Canada. So I would get dry patches under my nose or like the corners of my mouth, and now I don't have that whatsoever. So I feel like after taking that online skin quiz and now getting the products that really suit my skin needs, like my hydration in my skin has improved like exponentially. But I still get hormonal acne, I still get pimples here and there. These products don't necessarily help with those problem areas, but I feel like my overall skin texture has gotten better and it's gotten smoother, and I don't think it could have gotten smoother, but apparently it can. I will say I'm not a fan of the day serum because it leaves like this sticky texture on your fingers and on your skin. But I love the night serum and the night cream. It's just such high quality products and they feel so good on your skin. They feel luxurious and so soothing. Love it. Overall, self-care doesn't have to be about you looking good. It's about you feeling good. And I think having a great skincare routine is an awesome self-care activity. And like how self-care can be personalized and specific to every individual, so can skincare. For those who are new to skincare and you're overwhelmed by everything, or you're trying to use cleaner products, or you're just trying to figure out like what works best for you, please do check out Yours. I have all the good info and links linked down in the description box. There's also a code for you, so please do check it out. A great doable self-care activity is just to take some time to check in with yourself. Put your phone away, put all your electronic devices away, make sure they're all turned off, and just sit with yourself. Sometimes the reason why we're not feeling too good and we're just anxious and just really on edge is because we're out of touch. and we gotta recenter, refocus, and get grounded. Perhaps write a letter to yourself. Sit down and address all the things you've done up to this point, all the wins. Write out your gratitude. Maybe you just want to spill out your thoughts and feelings. Do that as well. But if you're especially writing about the good qualities that you possess, say it aloud. Read it back to yourself. Hear those words. Sometimes we're not feeling too good because we often don't take time to celebrate ourselves and to acknowledge how much good we are doing and how far we've come. And maybe a way for you to recenter is to acknowledge that. You can meditate. Now, I'm not saying you gotta have your back against the wall, you gotta sit crisscross applesauce and just close your eyes and just listen to silence for 30 minutes, but you could go outside and listen to the sounds of nature, or you could do a guided meditation through an app or through a YouTube video. Or maybe do a gentle physical activity like yoga or stretching. Spend a bit of time on the mat and just bring awareness to your body, to the parts of your body that need that extra love and attention. Sometimes a much needed yoga session is the ultimate self-care experience. Or do a tarot reading if you're into that. Maybe it's about sitting down and getting in touch with your spiritual side. Ask for guidance and support in the areas you're struggling in. See how you're currently doing and see what you need to work on. Overall, checking in just means just taking time for yourself. And sometimes we are so busy and preoccupied with our responsibilities and everything that's outside of us that maybe the reason why we don't feel too good is because we haven't filled up our own cup. Self-care is about setting boundaries and graciously letting go of things and people who no longer serve you for your highest good. Since we live in a day and age where we do almost everything on an electronic device, whether that be, you know, sending emails, taking pictures and videos, storing audio files and whatnot, we accumulate a lot of stuff on our electronic devices. A great self-care activity is to take some time to do a digital declutter. Delete or file away any emails, notes, voice memos, photos, and videos. Do this with your phone, your tablet, and your laptop. Even declutter people you follow on social media. Do the accounts you follow uplift you? Do you genuinely want to keep following those accounts? If not, let them go. A digital declutter may not seem like a transformative or profound self-care activity, but it is so needed. You're gonna feel a lot better when you have hundreds of videos and photos deleted, and when your desktop is nice and neat. I mean, you can tell by my personality type and my astrological sign, I'm a Virgo. I like things neat and tidy, and I hope you do too. Yes, I know that pampering yourself is usually the first thing that people think of as self-care, especially on social media, and it can kind of come off a surface level like, oh yeah, put a sheet mask on and that'll solve your issues. But I really want to say you should totally go for it. Totally indulge and pamper yourself. Because like I said before, self-care isn't always about looking good for others. It's about you feeling good. And if pampering yourself is what makes you feel good, then totally do it. I'm not saying you gotta go make a nail or hair appointment, or you gotta go get a facial or a massage. I mean, if that's what you want to do, then go for it. But I'm saying that you can totally take some time at home to maybe do a mani-pedi, or to do a sheet mask, or to indulge in a bubble bath, or take a long shower. Pampering can be finding your signature scent, whether that's perfume or a deodorant. Pampering can also be about putting makeup on. Even if you're working from home and nobody needs to see you, you can totally just put on some makeup if that makes you feel better. Maybe there's a different makeup style you'd like to try. So try it, have fun. Pampering is fun, and you're meant to be playful and relaxed and at ease. In conclusion for this one, go pamper yourself, okay? Go do it right now. Actually, no, not right now, because do you mind just finishing this video first and then going and pampering yourself? Yeah? Okay, cool. Alrighty, this is the last one. This is kind of like checking in with yourself, but I find that the written word can be a very powerful self-care tool. I know that journaling can be daunting for those who don't do it or haven't done it in a while, because like, what do you journal about? Like, do I just write my feelings? Do I write about the stuff I want to complain about? Do I journal for like an hour? Do I have to journal like every day? Like, what do I do? The answer is, do what works for you with whatever you've got. If you only have 10 minutes, then journal for 10 minutes. If you wanna write about your feelings, write about your feelings. It is trial and error at the end of the day. You can do stream of consciousness journaling. That's where you just sit down and just write whatever that comes to mind, Or you can do prompt journaling if you're feeling up to that. So I have a journaling routine video that you can check out. It is linked in the cards if you want to see how I journal. But in the morning, I answer 6 questions, and these questions come from the holistic psychologist, and I find them very useful. And I find that on the days that I don't do them, my day is kind of whack and I don't feel like I'm fully grounded. So check that video out. If you are ever feeling overwhelmed, cluttered, or you're feeling like there's way too much going on, just turn to a blank page in your notebook and write it out. If you have someone in your life who's willing to like listen to you and have the space for you just to vent it out, do that too. I don't want you to bottle it up, because if you're not expressing it, you're hiding it, you're internalizing it, you're just pushing it down, and that's not going to be healthy for you. So get it out of your system, okay? And that is it. Those are my 6 easy, practical, realistic, and useful self-care activities that you can do like right now for you to live a more peaceful, productive, and mindful life. Let me know your thoughts down in the comments below. Are you gonna try any of these self-care activities? What self-care activities do you have in your daily life that you do? Because I would love to hear them. I would totally be open to learning and trying out more self-care activities, because we can never have too much self-care, honestly. And yeah, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you haven't already. Make sure that notification bell is turned on so you don't miss a video from me. And yeah, I guess I will see you in the next one. Bye.